have Vishal Malik right here with us, and my quick question from her will be, I'm posing this question because she's attending this Magala Dialogue first round of all the sessions she was attending, and she spoke about Kashmir. So quickly we go to her. Vishal, what was the crux of this session you just attended on Kashmir, and what outcome do you care expect from this particular seminar?
It was a very comprehensive dialogue, roundtable discussion on the current situation. I spent 101 days of curfew in Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir post scrapping of Article 370-35A. So it was pertinent to mention the ground situation, what people are going through, and how important it is to find a peaceful solution to it. And the only sane solution is to give Kashmir people the right to freedom as per the UN resolutions, because we have given 50 years to bilateral. And Shimla and Tashkent, and you have Lahore Agreement, Agra Summit, Four Points of General Musharraf, and many others. Each time India has ditched out, and now especially after scrapping of Article 370, they've surpassed all international norms, treaties, multilateral and bilateral agreements. So it is very, very important for the world to rise up and look at the gravity of the situation and the repercussions of the chronic nature of this conflict, especially after February 27th when nuclear power through exchange. So this is something which is not linked to the region or between India and Pakistan. This is definitely a global issue. It's in the UN and it must be enforced by the resolutions, and sanctions must be imposed on
India. And what's Pakistan doing?
And I have appealed to the Pakistani state also that their policy must be more institutionalized. There must be at least minimum 5 to 10 year state policy on Kashmir, on how to internationalize it, how to take it to international mechanisms, especially the UN. There's special procedures, committees, rapporteurs within the UN, because for 50 years we've been busy in bilateralism. So now I think all energies, all diplomatic focus must be on internationalizing the UN platform.
Thank you, Shanda.